Hello, and welcome to another episode of A Toy Store Near You. I'm Brian Volkweiss, and this is a very special episode. It's actually not about a toy store at all. It is about the Gerald Ford Museum, which is located in Oh, we're doing the Tardy's Collector's Corner? Oh, sorry. Owned by Gavin and Deanna Willard, also in Grand Rapids. Okay, never mind. Forget what I said about Gerald Ford's library, which is actually kind of cool, except they don't really talk about Watergate, which is a little weird. But Tardy's Collector's Corner is an A-plus store in a great city, and the owners, Gavin and Deanna. Deanna, by the way, no relationship to Deanna Troy. That was the first question I asked her, but no relationship. They are awesome owners. I've actually met them a couple times. They were at like C2E2, the most wonderful people. They not only care about their store, they not only care about their customers, but they obviously, as you'll see in this episode, care a lot about their city, Grand Rapids, Michigan. So the next time you're there, please check it out. You will not be disappointed, and I hope you enjoy this episode.
About 30 miles up the Grand River from Lake Michigan is Grand Rapids. Grand Rapids is the first city in the U.S. to add fluoride to its drinking water. So let's drink to that. And as we celebrate these great achievements, let's toast to Gerald R. Ford, a native son who became the 38th president, but not so great with his footwork. Pop a top and crack a can, because Grand Rapids is now known as Beer City, USA. After a few pints of locally brewed craft beer, walk a few blocks south to Tardy's Collector's Corner. Opened in 1979 by Kirby and Deb Tardy as a comic book shop, and in 2015 bought by Gavin and Dina Willard, who now continue their legacy.
We specialize in mostly comic books, but we've introduced toys so heavily that we're both.
Clap.
We've been shopping here since 2003.
Yeah.
So it's like we basically grew up coming here in our adult life.
It's our local store. When we bought it, it was more just a comic book store, and we turned it into a comic / toy store. We specialize in old school comic books, anything up from the 40s all the way up through old Monster Mag toys, anything from the 70s up to current for toys. We try and have things that you're not going to be able to find just anywhere else. My boy, Monstor. So we bought this, we cleaned it all up, we had it way before we bought the shop, and it's been here ever since. This thing is super cool, 80s nostalgia. Monstor has a cool history. When they came out with this design, they came out with four different shells like this. They came out with Monstor, a Space One, a Genie One, and a Medieval One, I think. They guaranteed a certain amount of revenue above and beyond what they were getting out of their normal Coronaut machines. None of the retailers that bought these machines ever hit that amount. So they ended up making a class action lawsuit and suing for this. So we got the machine, we got the booklet, and we got the sheet of paper saying that they were doing a class action lawsuit for this thing. And he's just a static figure in our store. We set the candy in the side, it's fully functional. We set the amount of candy that you get out to 1980s portions. So you put in a quarter and you get like a fistful of candy.
In front of me are my collection of my pet monsters. Made in 1986 by the American Greetings Company. My pet monster was originally marketed towards boys, but I didn't care, I still wanted him. My pet monster keeps all the bad guys away, but he's still your friend. We got here the classic My Pet Monster, the My Football Monster, and the My Monster Pets. They're little puppets, just like little popples. Those are pretty cool too. I love Popples.
Pop goes the Popple.
My Pet Monster also came out with a live action movie and an animated TV series.
Monster Love Max.
When we introduced toys to the business, it brought in a completely different clientele. There's a ton of people that we weren't even on their radar because they thought we only carried old books and stuff.
We've essentially doubled our clientele. People love the toys and then they can get their comic books too. It's like a one-stop shop and people dig it.
Here is where a lot of our newer stuff is. Our Marvel Legends stuff, all of our NECA horror figures, all of our 8-inch stuff. We're big into monsters and creatures, and so we have the Elvira Ouija board, we have the Ghostbusters trap.
Ghost trap's sick.
There's so much toys back here. All reactions behind me. A little bit of everything. One of the things that it's kind of hard to think about for vintage toy stores is the fact that there's not a place to just buy and wholesale this stuff. It literally has to be found. People have to bring in collections. We have to go out to yard sales and estate sales. Usually we're up before the sun is, going out and hunting down things. Some of the stuff we get from distributors like Diamond from NECA, Hasbro, places like that. But a lot of the stuff we actually have to wait for it to come in. So we are really lucky to have such a full store right now. We usually do about a dozen conventions a year, if not more.
Conventions are a big way for us to show our product to other people who don't normally shop in our area.
If you came to our booth and enjoyed a sliver of this, this is 1/10 of what's in the store.
We've gained quite a few customers who seen us at Indianapolis, and then they say, oh, you got a store? I'm gonna drive all the way up there and see what you have. And they become customers for life.
Only one man is tough enough to stop the evil outlaw Tex-Tex. He's Brave Star.
The Brave Star Fort Kyrian playset in the box. This thing is still sealed in the box from 1980. I don't even know the date on this. Horrible. 1986. The fact that this still survived in this condition and it has never been opened, never been played with is beyond amazing.
Outlaw Scuzz's days in Fort Kyrian jail are numbered.
And Brave Star is such a weird line because it's a Wild West show set in space.
Brave Star!
In a distant time and faraway place, the planet of New Texas floats deep in space.
So it's a weird juxtaposition of old school meets like new stuff.
Brave Star. He was tough. He was brave. He had strange animal powers. But could he save New Texas alone?
One of my favorite things about old toys is instead of them showing pictures of the figures or the vehicles or the playsets, they actually drew a painting. They commissioned somebody to do box art for stuff. The graphics on the box are sick. It's just a cool series that I don't know who thought of it, but it is amazing.
This set is pretty wild because it spreads across so wide. You got a command center, a bank, a jail, and you can have them completely open up side by side. But if you put them together a certain way, you can actually fold the entire play set, put it in fortress mode so it can protect itself. And I guess making this toy, they might have realized that it might be a little too pricey for some people because you could buy the entire thing together, or they actually sold them in separate parts. So if you want to save a little money, you could just buy just a part of it. So that's probably why it's valuable, because there's so many portions of it, but not the entire whole. So if you got the whole thing, that's as rich as the Kyrium that they had in the show. So Brave Star is an animated series from the 80s from Filmation, the same people that gave us He-Man and She-Ra and Ghostbusters, not the real Ghostbusters, Ghostbusters.
Let's go, Ghostbusters!
Speaking of that show, they had made a villain for that show called Tex-Hex, but they were like, no, we can't use Tex-Hex in Ghostbusters. We gonna make a whole nother show just for this character to be the villain, and then we get Brave Star.
Has the evil Tex-Hex finally won? Or is Fort Kyrian safe with Brave Star? Only you know the answer. Neutralaser, command center, bank, jail set, and figures each sold separately. Batteries not included.
We know our customers. I mean, like, we see our customers more than we see family. Most of these guys we see at least once a week, if not more.
I appreciate being part of the community you find at Tardy's Collector's Corner.
It's just a small little shop packed full of amazing stuff.
You walk in there and you can't help but smile and know that things are going to be okay.
They have lots of toys there that you can play with, and they have lots of comic books there.
It actually smells like books, like a shop should. The amount of toys, the selection, the availability.
They care about the customers. They do a pull and hold system. They do a bonus program. They'll put stuff aside for you if they think you might like it.
And the willingness of Gavin and Dee to go above and beyond to find that special piece that you needed for your collection.
Things that you don't know you need.
Is unbelievable. unbelievable.
Comics and toys are our passion, and that's why Gavin and Deanna work so hard every day to keep excellent stock coming in.
We would not be customers of Tardy's Collector's Corner for a combined 51 years between the two of us if it weren't for their great selection of toys and comic books, the customer-driven atmosphere of their shop, and the vast knowledge and exceptional customer service of Gavin and Deanna.
A lot of these guys, this is their favorite place to be because they'll come in, they'll chit-chat for a little while, they'll hang out, look through some comic books, buy a few things, look through some toys, and just kind of unwind from the day.
Remarkable toys and games for your children. What are you so excited about now?
We have an original on-card farm boy Luke Skywalker.
Someone's coming, Chewie.
Who's there?
It's Luke Skywalker!
Original release, first 12. It's a little bit crunched on the card.
I do not want the Emperor's prize damaged.
But at the same time, it's an original from 77 Kenner release farm boy Luke. Awesome figure.
Hey everybody, we are building a flag today.
The Gerald R. Ford continues our tradition of building quality ships.
And we're going to build the USS flag live on social media.
Brett, say hello.
Hello.
There's B, Matt, Joe's back there running through parts. These guys are just building the base right now.
We had something like 30 people come to the store and watch it be built.
No one would have appreciated more the honor of having a carrier named after him than President Ford.
Look at this. The expert in the room, Joe Crazy Bill in the house. Oh my God. I don't need you guys anymore. We got the books.
We ended up having, I think, 35 or 40 people watching our live video as we were building a toy and just shooting the breeze while we were putting it together.
We gather to christen a ship whose namesake personified integrity.
This is a deck with a CK deck yes. Clip. This is what holds the entire top of this enormous thing.
Bless this ship, her sponsor, the builders and crew as we look forward to the day when she may be underway and at sea in your service.
It is so cool. It's so big that it's not even just a playset. It's a display for other toys. So as you can see, we've got vehicles on top, we have vehicles all around the base. It's so big that it is a toy and also a shelf at the same time.
May God bless the ship and all who sail her.
And 2019 was our store's 40th anniversary. It's been a staple in the community since 1979.
We had comic book artist Eric Powell in store, which was a huge deal for us. He worked on books like The Goon. He worked for Marvel and DC. It was a blast.
We did an auction for some of our cutouts that we have on our walls, and we donated half of those profits to the Humane Society. We got to see the dogs come out, and we got, you know, pictures with the dogs and stuff, so it was very special.
Also, we do a lot of Toys for Tots drives throughout the year. We did a huge thing with the Michigan Ghostbusters here locally and did this massive toy drive over around Christmas, and it was just the most fun that you could have.
They both of them thought hard to give back to the community. And one of the things they did very early on was to just put comics outside so people who needed some reading to pick it up.
When we order comic books, we don't always sell through. So we put together these little 3-pack bundles and we set them in front of our store for people to grab for free. While they're walking through the neighborhood, give them something to read and hopefully it'll make their day.
They donate comics to hospitals. They give comics to young people as they walk in. Just have some of these. It's not about just business. It's about what the business means.
We love Monster Toys so much, we even paid to have our own store exclusive. This is Robot Monster, Roman. From Hop Toys. Hop Toys stands for High on Plastic. And our exclusive is the glow-in-the-dark skeleton. He even has a little glow-in-the-dark face on his helmet.
So we have a problem with buying. We have a lot of stuff.
This guy right here.
I have a lot of problems with buying. I buy basically every collection that comes in for comic books or toys. And it got to the point where we ended up with 4 full storage units of stuff. So we decided instead of just keeping it in storage, what we should do is open up a second store. We kind of had an idea for somebody who could run it, Mr. Court Johnson.
Well, running a comic shop's always been my dream job. I started shopping at Tardy's Collector's Corner. It's probably been 28 to 29 years now. When Gavin Indiana took over, I still continued being a customer and then talked about opening up the second location.
We wanted to try Allegan, Michigan because it's a small town, but small towns can be fantastic.
The community is smaller, so they get involved more.
We've got lots of things coming up. Bridge Fest, sidewalk sales, and Rolling on the River. They have different bands on every Friday night. So lots of things where we have opportunities to get customers up here.
We have way too much stuff and you have to come get some of it.
Now you can see it at two locations.
Damn. Sounds like a commercial.
Uh-oh.
It's Mask, where illusion is the ultimate weapon. Mask Boulder Hill playset.
The Mask Boulder Hill playset is insane how big this thing is. Big considering how small the figures are. This line was really, really cool. They kind of have the perfect match between Transformers and G.I. Joe, and they really are starting to get the love right now. I think it went three or four series of figures coming out, but this was their, like, big playset. Just a cool piece. The boulder comes off.
Oh, yeah?
And there's a turret that comes out. There's a jail in the back.
Surrender, prisoner.
This all moves. I mean, there's so much stuff to do with this. It's just a cool piece for your collection.
So Boulder Hill was, like, the secret base for Mask. It looks like a gas station next to a rock hill, but it's actually underneath a secret base. And this playset, they went all out. This thing is huge. I love that the gas station sign and the gas pumps turn into laser weapons. Like, I know gas is expensive, but hold on, I'm gonna pay for it. You don't need to turn the pump into a weapon to attack me, okay? Also, Mask has one of the most awesome, just electric, energetic theme song intro openings I have seen on an 80s cartoon. It is pure 80s theme song with this one.
Mask Crusaders, working overtime, fighting crime.
I can't believe how far we've come in just 7 years, and I can't wait to see what 7 years down the road looks like.
Basically, my dream job. I've always wanted to do something like this. Really knew that I couldn't ever do it on my own, so this was just the perfect opportunity for me.
I hope that we just keep growing, keep getting more collections, we keep getting more fans that come in and love to take a look at things.
Love going there. You're part of something that's bigger than just picking up a comic book. You're part of a family.
Tardy's Collector's Corner is the best.
The best thing to hear when a fan comes in and picks up this toy that they've had when they were a child and say, oh my God, I can't believe this. I used to have this when I was a kid. It's such a cool feeling to be able to put that back in their life.
Gavin Deanna, it's about their home, and that shop is their home. It's about their community, and that shop's their community.
I can't believe that I get to do this as a job.